So here we have the derivative of x times the inverse cotangent of x over 9. So we knew to take this derivative that we're definitely going to have to use a formula for the derivative of the inverse cotangent. So let me just go ahead and write that over in the corner for us. So the derivative of inverse cotangent, or arc cotangent, whichever you like to write, is negative 1 over 1 plus x squared for all x's. Okay, so let's use this formula to take the derivative of this equation. So here we actually have the product of x and this inverse cotangent. So we're going to have to use the product rule to take the derivative. So that's going to equal first times the derivative of the second piece plus the second piece times the derivative of the first. Okay, so then to continue, we're going to have to take the derivative of the inverse cotangent of x over 9. Okay, so my formula gives me the derivative of the inverse cotangent of x. But in what I'm actually trying to take the derivative of, I've got the inverse cotangent of x over 9. So you can think of this as a composition of functions, if you want. And so x over 9 is sort of like the inner function. So we're going to have to use a chain rule to take this derivative. So basically to do that, I'm going to take the derivative of the inverse cotangent as I normally would, but evaluate it at that inner function. So in other words, negative 1 over 1 plus x over 9 squared. And make sure you square that whole quantity. Okay, so the derivative evaluated at the inner function. And the other part of the chain rule is that I need to multiply by the derivative of the inner function. So the inner function in this case is x over 9, which you can also think of as 1/9 times x. So the derivative of that is going to be just 1/9. Okay, and then if I continue, plus inverse cotangent of x over 9 times the derivative of x, which is just 1. So we finished actually taking the derivative at this point, but we can clean up our answer a good bit here within this first term. So let's work on that. So I'm going to take this x. So, okay, I've got the product of three pieces, x times this fraction and then times 1/9. So I can write this as negative x over 1 plus, now x over 9 quantity squared, that means I square both the numerator and the denominator. So I can write that as x squared over 81. And then all of that is times the fraction 1/9. And then I still have over here my inverse cotangent. Now what I can do to make this nicer is distribute this 9 in the denominator. So you can think about distributing this 9 to both terms like this. So this becomes negative x over 9 plus, and that would be 9x squared over 81, which would reduce to x squared over 9, plus still this inverse cotangent. Okay, so we've reduced this a good bit, but maybe you're still bothered by that fraction in the denominator of the fraction. To get rid of that, we can kind of do a little trick and multiply both the top and bottom of this fraction by 9. So we're essentially multiplying by 9 over 9 and therefore not changing the value of the fraction overall. We're just multiplying by 1. But what this does, it gives us negative 9x on the top. And then we do the same thing in the bottom we did before. We distribute this 9 to both terms here like this. And so on the bottom, we're now going to get 81 plus x squared. And so this answer's a little nicer. But the main point of this exercise was, of course, taking the derivative of the cotangent and particularly using the chain rule while doing so.